Hello, in this video I would like to discuss five topics. The first topic is SAATE. The full form of SAATE is Sustainable Action for Transforming Human Capital in Education. So E stands for Education. So this is an initiative taken up by NITI Aayog. So NITI Aayog is with a project called Role Model States. So Role Model States is to create a good states with good functioning of health and education system. So this Role Model States initiative is by NITI Aayog, and under this project one initiative is SAATE. So SAATE looks after two sectors, they are health and education in all states. So for example, recently NITI Aayog applied this SAATE in Orissa, in the state of Orissa. So under this initiative it has merged schools. So merging of schools is done in Orissa recently. All those schools which are having very less poor enrollment, that is less than 20 students per school, when they are having this much less enrollment, these schools are now all merged. Like for example, 8,000 schools are merged in this manner in 15 districts of Orissa. So how to bring up these kind of solutions in education field, in the field of health, is what NITI Aayog does in states. So this is one recent example of Orissa where the SAATE is functioning. The next topic is AA framework. The full form of AA framework is Account Aggregator Framework. So this is brought forward recently by Reserve Bank of India. This is to provide easy services to customers. So in giving loans or other banking procedures, to make these procedures easy, Account Aggregator Framework is brought forward by RBI. So this is helping with financial necessities. So financial necessities of individuals or businesses. So where they do not need to go through a hefty procedure to avail loans or other procedures. So no documents are needed. So this is giving some easy banking services to public. So this helps not just individuals but also businesses, small and mid-sized businesses especially. This is helping. And under Account Aggregator Framework, there is a concept called Financial Information Report. So Financial Information this report has to be given by the provider. So the provider must be a bank. So all banks, the banks which integrate themselves with Account Aggregator Framework, have to give their financial information. So they are called financial information providers. So banks are the financial information providers. So the first bank to be linked with Account Aggregator Framework, or to be the first financial information provider, is IndusInd Bank. So IndusInd Bank in India is the first bank amongst all the banks that went live with Account Aggregator Framework of RBI in being the first financial information provider to RBI. So the next topic is World Cities Day. So World Cities Day 2020 is celebrated every year and on 31st October. So in the same manner, this year also World Cities Day is celebrated. So this started first in 2014 in Shanghai, China. So this is about reiterating on the importance of communities, both local communities and international communities. So this also speaks about some important topics regarding urbanization, like global urbanization, sustainable urban development, and challenges in urbanization. And the theme of 2020 is valuing our communities and cities. So this is the particular theme of 2020 this year. So valuing our communities and valuing our cities. The next topic is Arogya One. So Arogya One is present in Kevadia in Gujarat. So Kevadia in Gujarat, we know that there is Statue of Unity present there. So Arogya One is inaugurated by our Prime Minister in Statue of Unity complex. So around Statue of Unity, there are others present, other things inaugurated by Prime Minister, like Zoological Park and all. So this is called a complex. So in this complex, there is also Arogya One. So this Arogya One is present in a span of 17 acres, and this is about for providing space for meditation and yoga. This Arogya One is special because it has got 380 species, different species of trees and plants. So these trees and plants have got medicinal values. So this is also a center for Ayurveda, because this has got 380 species of medicinal trees and plants. This has become a center of Ayurveda. So Aarogyavan is also important with Ayurveda. And this Statue of Unity complex, apart from Aarogyavan, holds Sardar Patel Zoological Park and Geodesic Aviary Dome. So these two things are also present in the complex. The last topic for today is World Psoriasis Day 2020. So World Psoriasis Day is celebrated every year on October 29th. This is to bring awareness about psoriasis disease. So we know psoriasis disease is a skin disease. This is a chronic disease. That means it develops over time into more dangerous form. So this is an autoimmune disease. That is, the immune cells destroy healthy cells, and that is called an autoimmune disease. This is a condition that is formed inside the body by cells itself. And the theme of 2020 World Psoriasis Day is informed. So one has to be informed about what psoriasis is, because in majority of cases this is misdiagnosed or undiagnosed. So this goes undiagnosed and this goes misdiagnosed. People tend to think that it is a small skin disease, and they don't think that it is a condition of psoriasis. So for this reason, the theme is kept as informed. So one has to be clearly informed what psoriasis is and what symptoms it clearly has got. So this has got high prevalence, and because of its complex nature, this has got no one single nature. It has complex nature. So because of that, people tend to ignore that. And so it is going misdiagnosed and undiagnosed. So to bring awareness in this particular disease of psoriasis, World Psoriasis Day is celebrated on 29th October. The theme is informed. So these are the five topics for today, and thank you.